Now, this is the video that I have been waiting to make for some time now. As you know, I am a lover of great optics. I'm a lover of low light optics. It doesn't make any sense to me to purchase optics that are not made for low light, because that is when most surveillance will occur. That is when nighttime hunting occurs, in the last 30 minutes of hunting or the first 30 minutes in the morning of hunting, dawn and dusk. And based on that, and the fact that I am not using these binoculars for just bird watching, that's a very limited use of binoculars to me. Surveillance and preparatory tool set is what I like to focus in on. And as such, I have heralded these Steiner Night Hunters in 8x56 as the kings, the alpha male of low light. Is it still the alpha male of low light with the presence of this unit on the table? We will soon find out. This is the Fujinon. I made a short about this particular unit, and I will continue with a full-fledged review today with this particular unit. I love this Fujinon FMTR-SX model. However, I will tell you this, whereas this is very specifically made for the heritage of military police use that Steiner is known for, these Fujinons are not necessarily tactical nor made with a police military heritage. What do you mean by that, Bose? Well, let's start with the case. You have a very nice case that the unit comes in. It is soft. It is nylon. It is rip resistant, with rip stop nylon being used. It's tacked very well and stitched very well for usage with a belt loop. And you would use the belt loop with this in conjunction with the strap going around your shoulders, just based on the weight of this particular unit. But note, every single animal in that forest knows that you're there now. Why, Fujinon? Why put Velcro on this particular case? All right, you're forgiven. You're forgiven because what's coming out is a fantastic unit that does deserve your look-see and your due diligence with your usage out in the field. I'm going to put the case back here and then start talking about this Fujinon with lens that are to absolutely die for. The lens as ground by Fujifilm in this Fujinon FMTR-SX is absolutely second to none. Yes, it does rival, in my personal opinion, the lens quality of the Night Hunters. However, as you will see by the end of this video, there is absolutely a reason to buy this Night Hunter in 8x56 from Steiner. Not the least of which is the heritage that comes with the Steiner nameplate. The FMTR-SX is Fujinon's marine model. It is 7x50 as opposed to the Steiner 8x56. 56mm objective lens, 50mm objective lens, 7 magnification. It is a hefty unit, but a beautiful one. Look at the armor coating with that beautiful green hue which comes with this Fujinon. It is an absolute workhorse. Armor coating, top to bottom. Fujinon embossed on the armor coat. You have here your screw-on for your tripod adapter. Nothing out of the ordinary thus far, right? Classic Poro prism shape. Fits nicely in the hand. And since there is no central focus knob here, you understand that focusing this particular unit is very similar to the focusing on your Steiners. Independent focus of each one of the eyepieces. So let's start with the top, the ocular lens cover. If we look at the quality of this ocular lens cover, hard plastic. I wish they would have made this a little bit softer, but it will do. It is not the hard plastic which is on the less expensive Mariner unit. It is somewhat pliable, and I don't expect this particular lens cover, the ocular lens cover, to crack with extreme temperatures on the lower end of the spectrum. I expect this to last. What do you not see here? You see only one strap inlet. You don't see one here, which means that you are keeping this on your strap by having it laced through. I don't have this particular unit laced, and I will show you why in a moment. As I said, this particular Fujinon is independent focus. That means that you will be closing one eye, focusing from this ring, this particular side, and then closing this by either covering it up here, and then focusing your other eye. Independent focus. And the value to that is, once it is focused at a far away distance, generally more than 20 yards away, I like to do it at 60 yards away, the unit stays in focus from that point to infinity. That is all nice and dandy. Eye cups do not move up and down. Just like on the Steiners, which has a much more pliable eye cover. As you can see, the quality of this Steiner eye cover is greater and better than the Fujinon's, for sure. As you can see, the Steiners and the Fujinon's have the eye cups that do not move up and down. There's only two positions. Up and down. With the Fujinon's, you don't have this curvature, which means that you do not have a block for the side of your eye, which I frankly like. If you wear contacts or if you have 20/20 vision without correction, you will love this particular eyepiece because it will block out the light coming in from the side, which is very helpful when you have aberrant light in an urban setting through light posts, headlights, taillights, etc. However, if you wear glasses like me, these get in the way of you getting a clear sight picture. In fact, it gets in the way of you being able to use this at all. The only way that I can use this particular Steiner unit is to put the eyepiece down. Simply fold this pliable rubber down like this and out of the way. Now, here is an issue that comes up immediately between these two units. Notice how when I fold up this eyepiece on the Steiners, I am covering up partially the focus wheel, which allows me to turn and focus this particular unit. You see that? When I fold the eye cup down, notice that the folding covers the turning wheel of this particular ocular lens focus point. So when I try to focus this, it becomes difficult because I am moving this eyepiece also. Notice the focus element is not moving, only the eyepiece is moving at this point. If I put my finger down here and focus the actual ring, it's difficult because this thing will turn along with it and it becomes somewhat of a hassle. Not a difficulty, just a hassle. With the Fujinons, when you also turn these down into the lower position, you notice that the focus knob on the independent focusing system is completely accessible. Wonderful. Because when I focus these, when I put these eye cups into their lower position, which means basically folding these rubber eyepieces down like that, I still have full access to the focus knob on each one of the eyes. I love that. With the Steiners, not so much, like I just said. I appreciate also the very wide knurling and ability to use with gloves on this focus ring. That width allows me, when I have gloves on, to have full access to the focusing of this particular unit. I love that. With the Steiners, with gloves on, this becomes challenging. Just based on the fact I have much less real estate for the focusing element than I do on the Fujinons. When you get to this level of quality and this level of review, you are looking at these finer points. That is really what distinguishes elements in the alpha class of optics. It's the small things that you are looking at. So the focus rings, great on these Fujinons. I love them. Look at the shape of the Fujinons. Like I said, classic poroprism, very large real estate area to wrap your hands around. I like to hold this particular unit by the barrels and use this one-handed. And that is very simple because once, like I said, this unit is focused at 60 meters, you are good to go. You don't need to touch this focus ring again. Very similar to the sports autofocus of the Steiner Night Hunters. But look at the shape. Notice that the shape of the Steiners is much more streamlined. That streamlined shape allows for, in my opinion, a better grip and easy grip of this particular Steiner unit. I love holding, carrying, and using these Steiners. And like I said, when I hold on to the barrel, notice that Steiner has made these an indent onto, by armoring, onto the barrel. And therefore, when you hold here, it makes an easy place for your fingers to hold on to the ledge produced by this particular feature on the barrel itself. Not there on the Fujinons. With the Fujinons, we have these elements on the barrel itself, which allows for some traction to be formed with your fingers, but nothing compared to that ledge on these Night Hunters. And in addition, when placed like that and looked at like this, you can see that the Fujinons are obviously much thicker in the barrel area than these Steiner Night Hunters. You appreciate these Steiner Night Hunters and the engineering that went in to the design of that unit as you use these Night Hunters. Moving on. I have showed you in another video how the click lock system works in attaching the straps onto the units. With the Fujinons, we have a classic strap attachment, lacing up the strap onto a point here in the back, closest to the body of the unit, right? Now, what does that produce when this unit is held on your chest? It produces, based on the weight of this particular unit, a cant. You will find that this unit does not rest perpendicular, or rather parallel to your chest. There is a cant. And it is produced based on the placement of these attachment points for the strap. With the Steiners, you have classic click lock, in which the positioning of the click lock attachment point makes it so that this unit rests completely perpendicular to your chest and is more comfortable to hold. Click lock, if you remember, push here, take out. As I said before, the click lock has a weakness. It is inherent. If something happens to this particular attachment point in the field, you are SOL, because you cannot attach a classic strap to this unit. Click lock. The strap that came with the Fujinons, nothing to write home about. Classic neoprene, Fujinon written on it. Bar tacks here. Very thin nylon, although quality nylon. I like the quality of the Steiners more. Steiner has the same type of neoprene on it. Nothing really to write home about. In that regard, both of these are very similar, with the exception of the attachment point being click lock, attachment point being classic lace up on the Fujinons. Let us go to the adjustability of your pupil distance or interpupil distance. Very nice. This is not easy and it's not hard. It is just right. Very similar to these Steiners. However, with the Steiners, notice it is easy. Once there is movement being produced, it is easy to change the interpupil distance. However, for some reason, inside, they have made the engineering so that once the unit is in place and you have chosen the interpupil distance, it stays in place. There is something in internal to this hinge that makes this engineering superb. It is not simple friction that's holding this in place. There is something more. What that something is, I could not tell you, but there is something internally in this hinge that gives this better engineering in setting of that interpupil distance. Since we've already spoken about the body distinctions between these two units, let's move to the objective lens covers. In this regard, Fujinon, please do something more with these covers. ...50mm objective lens from the diameter edge to edge, right? Very basic rubber objective lens covers. What is the real weakness of this, you say? Let me tell you. Notice how it's attached. Look closely. It's attached, is not removable. And if this rips, you're SOL. Because this piece right here is attached to the body of the barrel. And therefore, if something happens to this cover, you're not going to just purchase a replacement and be able to do this aesthetically pleasing to you anytime soon. Attachment point is built in. I don't like that. If we look at the Steiner Night Hunters, you see that the attachment point is designed with the click lock system in mind. The quality of these lens covers I have spoken about before is superb. Just look at this. It's been engineered to fit directly in with a pleasing level of clicking onto the body of the binocular. And it is removable. So that if something happens to this particular objective lens cover, buy another, put it in place, insert it, and you're done. Absolute wonderful engineering with these Steiners as far as the covers are concerned. Not so much with these. I do appreciate the fact that the lens covers sit very firmly inside the inner area of the barrel, but they're not very pleasing to use. I find more enjoyment from the engineering and thought that went into the Steiner objective lens covers. Now we get to the last part. Bose, enough with the engineering and the quality distinctions between the Fujinon and the Steiners. What did you think of the sight picture? Absolutely a tie between these two. I find that the usage of these Fujinons out in the field is easier for me. Why? Because of what I said earlier about the focus element here, the fact that the eyepieces are not occluding in any way nor hampering in any way the focus elements. Unlike this Steiner unit. We've already spoken about that point. It is a major point when you're using these out in the field. I also appreciate the way that the Steiners sit on my body. This, like I said, cants off to the side. However, sight picture with this 7x50 is absolutely crisp, clear. It is a night vision or nighttime low light alpha unit. It is the sharpest unit I have, period, bar none. The Steiners come 95% close to the sharpness that I can get with these Fujinons. However, these Fujinons are superior as far as the sight picture is concerned and the resolution of what you are looking at a distance. An elephant with a gnat on its ass, that gnat is not hiding anywhere with these Fujinons. Trust me. Now, you have seen the direct comparison of two of the best units for low light, bar none. Obviously, the rudimentary things, huh? The ability to sustain bumps, drops on the field, very similar. The waterproofing of these two units, very similar. Fog proofing, very similar. We're past all of those rudimentary small things, people. We are talking about the finer points of these two alpha units. You will not go wrong with either one of them. If given a choice of which one I like to take out in the field, if I had only one binocular that I could take with me, I would take the Fujinons. However, if I could take one unit with me and it wasn't a SOL type of scenario, a time and place in which my life is at stake, then I would take the Steiners. Better engineering for sure. You will love the Steiner Night Hunters. You will love these Fujinons. Weight difference between the two, Steiners weigh less, 43 ounces, and a tad bit more, I would say along the lines of about 50 ounces for these Fujinons. However, sight picture is immense with both of these. What about the field of view, Bose? Field of view is greater with the Steiner Night Hunters, definitely. However, that field of view distinction is not enough for me. I don't really need that great a field of view when I am viewing things at night, and therefore, it is a minor point to me. But the engineering of this Fujinon is absolutely incredible. Add this to your collection for alpha low light units. You will not be sorry. Add the Steiner to your collection of alpha low light units. This is a classic Steiner model. Best of the best, best engineering. You will love to just take this out and just look at how much thought went into it. That's it for today. Thank you for joining me as I share my love for great optics and put into the mix my thoughts on what the engineering quality is going into these wonderful binoculars. Take care, folks.